At the Bioengineering Laboratory at the Massachusetts General Hospital, we have a very long and very actually proud tradition of excellence in innovative research in order to optimize or improve the outcomes of patients with following hip and knee replacements. Our current focus of our research at the moment is to really visualize or quantify the kinematics of the hip and knee prosthesis after it has been implanted in patients and while the patients perform functional activities. Currently, the standard tests that we use, such as a plain radiograph or CT scan or MRI scan, they're all actually taken while patient is stationary. At our laboratory, we actually utilize very innovative research technique, which is non-invasive imaging tool, which actually allows us to visualize the kinematics of both hip and knee replacement implants in patients while patients perform functional activities. And these include gait or the walking, rising from the chair, or stair climbing. And actually, what we have actually learned, for example, in terms of total knee arthroplasty, is the importance of trying to mimic the kinematics of native knee following total knee arthroplasty, which is a challenge. And we're also learning that there's a significant variation from patient to patients. And secondly, for in case of total hip arthroplasty, what we're also learning is the importance that the position or optimal position to which we should place components may differ from the standard information that we've been using, which is a plain radiograph, and we're learning the importance of considering or taking into consideration a much more functional orientation, such as when patient is standing up, which does take into consideration of any spinal pelvic movement. So I think the focus, in the coming years, is trying to get more understanding of how we can actually make this information translate into optimizing the component orientation in patients with a total hip arthroplasty.